An object's velocity after t seconds is v of t equals 24 minus 2t feet per second. Part A, how many seconds does it take for the object to stop, meaning when is the velocity equal to zero? B, how far does a car travel during that time? And C, how many seconds does it take for the car to travel half the distance of part B? So for part A, to determine when the object stops, we're going to set the velocity or v of t equal to zero and solve for t. This would give us the equation 0 equals 24 minus 2t. So to solve for t here, we'd subtract 24 on both sides. So we have negative 24 equals negative 2t, and now we'll divide both sides by negative 2. So we have t equals 12, which means it takes 12 seconds for the object to stop. For part B, we want to know how far the car travels during this time, which means how far it's traveled from t equals 0 to t equals 12. Before we answer this though, let's look at the graph of our velocity function on the coordinate plane. Here it is. The first thing we should notice is that we can confirm the answer to part A. Notice at t equals 12, the velocity function value is 0. And therefore the object would be stopped. But we also know that distance equals rate times time. And notice how we have the rate or velocity along the vertical axis, and we have the time along the horizontal axis. Which means if we find the area under the velocity function and above the x-axis over this interval, it would give us the distance the object travels from t equals 0 to t equals 12. Now looking at the graph here, we could find this area by using the area formula of a triangle, but let's find this area using a definite integral, where the distance traveled would be equal to the integral of the velocity function from 0 to 12 seconds. Using the fundamental theorem of calculus, we'll now find the antiderivative function of 24 minus 2t, meaning we want to find a function that has a derivative of 24 minus 2t. Which would be 24t minus t squared. And now we'll evaluate this at the upper limit of integration of 12, then the lower limit of integration of 0, and then find the difference. But again, before we do this, notice that the derivative of 24t minus t squared is 24 minus 2t. So when t is 12, we'd have 24 times 12 minus 12 squared. And when t is 0, we'd have 24 times 0 minus 0 squared. Well, here we'll have 288 minus 144 minus, this would be 0. So this would give us 144. Which means from t equals 0 to t equals 12 seconds, the object travels 144 feet. If we go back to the graph just for a moment, notice how we have a right triangle with a base of 12 and a height of 24, where the area of a triangle is equal to 1/2 base times height. So in this case, we'd have 1/2 times 12 times 24, which would give us an area of 144 square units. So if this does verify, our answer for part B is correct. And off the last question, we want to know how many seconds does it take for the car to travel half the distance of part B. Well, in part B, we discovered that it traveled 144 feet. So if we divide this by 2 to find half, that would be 72 feet. So our goal is to find how long it takes for the car to travel 72 feet. Now, a couple of ways of doing this, but let's set this up as a definite integral. Let's let x equal the time to travel 72 feet. So our integral would be the integral of our velocity function, 24 minus 2t, from 0 to the unknown time, which we're calling x. And this must equal 72. So for the next step, we'll find the antiderivative function, which would be 24t minus t squared. Evaluate this at the upper limit of integration of x, then the lower limit of integration of 0. So this would give us 24x minus x squared minus, notice when t is 0, these are both 0, so we just have minus 0, and this must equal 72. So we want to solve the equation 24x minus x squared equals 72. Let's go ahead and set this equal to 0 and see if it factors. If we set this equal to 0, let's put the 0 on the left side, so we'd have 0 equals x squared minus 24x plus 72. And this does not factor, so we'll have to use the quadratic formula given here, where a equals 1, b equals negative 24, and c equals 72. So we'd have x equals negative 24, that's positive 24, plus or minus the square root of b squared, that's going to be negative 24 squared, minus 4 times a, which is 1, times c, which is 72, divided by 2 times a, which is 2 times 1. So here we'll have 24 plus or minus the square root of negative 24 squared minus 4 times 1 times 72 is equal to 288 divided by 2. The square root of 288 simplifies to 12 square root 2. So we have 24 plus or minus 12 square root 2 divided by 2. Breaking this up into two separate fractions, we have 24 divided by 2 plus or minus 12 square root 2 divided by 2. So we have x equals 12 plus or minus 6 square root 2. So it may appear there are two solutions for x, which is the time it takes to travel 72 feet. But remember, after t equals 12 seconds, the object has stopped. And therefore, 12 plus 6 square root 2 would not make any sense. So the exact time would be 12 minus 6 square root 2. But let's also get a decimal approximation for this. This will be approximately 3.5147 seconds. So to answer the question, it takes 12 minus 6 square root 2 seconds to travel 72 feet. We shouldn't give the rounded value for the time in seconds unless the directions tell us to. So we'll go ahead and enter 12 minus 6 square root 2 seconds. I hope this was helpful.